here in our block center where we do a lot of our whole group teaching. We're lucky enough to have the 70-inch touch display screen where students can use this as a computer, or it does have built-in software where we can use up to 10 points of touch, which is a huge advantage, especially for early childhood. We're doing a little yoga earlier.
Well done, everyone. That was great. Thanks for coming to Calypso's amazing 8th birthday party.
Well, that's a great spot right there. We can use this touch display, 10 points of touch, just like this. We use this for all sorts of practice, like sight words, number writing. We have videos that we use in the morning to get us up and moving. It also works as our nice book holder place here, because one of the things that I worked on this year was getting books easier for students to get access to. So we have baskets sitting out throughout the room, sorted by seasons or activities like farming and animals. Everything that's over here is at student level, including our sight words and a number grid. We've been working up to 30, which is why it's only up to 30 at this point. Students also have easy access to their cubbies to get items such as their handwriting notebook, their reader's notebook, and as well as their folders for writer's workshop. Like I said, it is also the block center, so students during center time have a variety of blocks, Legos, racetracks, and sorts of objects that they can do.
Our ABC Center, this is one of our centers where students will work in the afternoon.
We consider these our social learning centers, where students' main focus is to learn through play. Since we're in the ABC Center, we have all sorts of things on our shelf over here, including little tubs that we can sort objects by beginning sounds, ending sounds. There's even rhyming objects in there. They have jobs that they can work on the shelves as well, including wood pieces for our handwriting series, puzzles where we can put items in alphabetical order. There are sensory objects like little sand and salt tubs where they could practice writing words or letters. Typically, we have about 3 students in each center, so they do have a couple tables they can work at, but they have plenty of space they can sit and work during that time. They also use this area for our literacy stations. It becomes their word work area, so there's jobs on the shelves that deal with making rhyming words, dealing with beginning sounds and ending sounds at this time of the year. And the last thing you'll see up here is our All About Me board, where we will feature a different student each week, kind of like Star of the Week. Technology Center, which is another one of our centers in the classroom. This is one of our more flexible areas, because we do use it when students are working in whole group with me as well. They've got a table they can sit at to write on. It's a nice hard surface. It's also the most open center because you can walk through, so it's got good flow through it. We have good access to books, so even though it is the technology center, we still keep literacy as the main focus in our classroom. We have Legos as well. We have a large focus on robotics because we have access to things like our little mouse. We call him Squeaky. And we have our newest robot this year, which is our Cubetto that students are currently coding. They also have several seat options. We've got everything from wobble chairs to billabo chairs to this nice little cushion over here off to the side. Students use their iPads, which are located in the cart off to the side. Each student has their own, thanks to our district's one-to-one initiative. There are a variety of apps that we use for literacy, math, and coding during technology time. To our pretend center, this is often referred to as our housekeeping or house area, but we have a lot of different items that students can dress up with. They can act things out. We've got this nice puppet shelf over here. We have a whole shelf of different outfits, costumes, even some fake hair for the students to wear. There's different objects they can use to make their ensemble even more exciting. We do have a trampoline over here to let them really get their wiggles out if they're back here working. Even during the day, they can use this trampoline at any time. Back behind, we've got this nice kitchen set here that has our wonderful fake sink and fake oven and pots and pans and dishes, so they can pretend to cook some food for us, too. Because as I mentioned, too, before, it's important for students to learn through play. That's about how they best socialize and get to know each other and get to learn our social skills that we're working on. We even have puppets for our puppet shelf that they can act things out. You've got a nice baby over here so they can practice parenting skills already. We've got books and magazines and different baby clothes, purses, bags. We have money for them to practice using. And again, it's just a very open, flexible space for students to explore who they are and what they want to actually be in the future as well. In the Math Center. In the Math Center, you will find lots of different objects because students focus on learning one-to-one, which is counting one object at a time as they're learning number sense. The biggest addition this year was this entire cubby section of manipulatives, which include little bears. There's little trinkets like blocks and dominoes and rocks and seashells. Anything that's kind of different for students to either build with or to count or to sort. Those are some big concepts that we work on in kindergarten. We have counting trees to help with those one-to-one counting. We have different manipulatives, too, that you can use to count, create patterns, and to even start working on addition and subtraction. We work on... Of course, now I didn't find what I want. We work on building numbers as well, whether it's as simple as making flashcards or... matching numbers of objects, two numbers. We also, on the back side here, do have a number grid for them to use as reference. Right next to the Math Center, we have the Reading and Writing Center, where students will practice their writing skills, such as working on beginning sounds, or they might be labeling objects. We learn that labels tell us what things are. We create lists, and then we work up through personal narratives, persuasive writing. All of those concepts are reinforced through things that we have inside the center, including books that have labels. We have sorting boards for students to sort what objects go together, so they're matching labels and details. There are different magazines and notebooks and pictures for students to use in their writing and story creation. And there's still a large focus on letters and sounds. We do have puzzles that can be put in alphabetical order to create pictures as well. Another big component for students to use is a whiteboard. They love having that access to practice their writing and also play games on there to help with their literacy skills. Over in this part of the room, it's not a set center. This is more of a small group working area. So here at these grade tables is where I work with my small reading groups, math groups, or even science and social studies groups as students need. Students also have kind of an open floor plan here in this section so they can float between tables. Sometimes students in the math and reading and writing centers use these extra tables here if they need more space, even the one over here in the art and science center. But behind me here is our quiet room. Now, this is not a room that's meant for students that are having some behavioral issues to go into and quiet themselves down. Since this room is built with foam, it's a very fragile room. The main purpose for it is for students to use it as a recording booth. So if they're working on Seesaw, they're recording their reading, this is a great place for students to go into and to have a nice quiet environment. Because with 23, 5, and 6-year-olds in here, our room is hardly ever super quiet enough to get a nice recording. It does double back as a spot for students who really just need a quiet place to sit and calm down. It works for that as well. Now over in the Art and Science Center, I do mix art with science because we've got the nice sink here, we've got our water play, we've got our sand play for students to learn different science concepts. We also have our art easel so students can paint. Over here we have a variety of papers, we've got markers, pencils, colored pencils, crayons, pretty much anything you could wish for decorating things and being creative. Students that do feel extra proud of their work, they put them up over here on our art wall so they can display it for everyone to see. We have all sorts of different objects students can build with over here. Anything from cotton balls to popsicle sticks to a whole tray of different little tiny things like little letters and sequins and stars. We've got stickers and different materials that parents have donated over the years. We have Play-Doh so students can create and build with that as well. And all sorts of Play-Doh toys there. We have some new science kits that we got through a STEM grant that students can build ramps with. They can do sink and float with those activities as well. The little area over here is considered our Kinder Cove. It's a nice secondary quiet space for students to get out of our loud room to come sit. They can use this for recording on iPads. They can use it to read books to themselves or any other quiet activity that they need. It's just kind of a nice spot for students to sit so they aren't feeling so overwhelmed by everything else going on in our classroom. Thanks for coming in and taking a look at our classroom. Some of the most important things to remember when leaving here is that it's so important for us to have these little nooks and crannies in our classroom for students to not feel so overwhelmed, especially when it's oftentimes their first experience with school. It also helps us to reduce the ratio of students to teachers. During center times, there's usually 3 to 4 kids in each center, and that allows us to focus them on a task. They have partners to work with, but they also have our support. Also, everything that students need access to is at their level. Things that are higher up on the wall are things that either we need access to or they're kind of staples that students can reference, but not necessarily something they need.